Hello and welcome to the another tutorial of Zotero library references software that I use during my bachelor and master thesis in my university. Yeah, I started learning from bachelor and have been to use during my master's. It's been a long time since I was graduated. I'm not sure how many functions I remember. It's coincidence today when I was giving feedback to my brother for a report, I suggest him to use Citation library from Zotero. He happened to find little difficult. I can also agree on his thoughts. So I decided to make a simple video which will help others like my brothers who are writing a reports or thesis in a university level and are not known to Zotero and can use in a simple way. The Zotero itself is a standalone software that have many functions that we probably doesn't even need in our everyday life unless you are working for libraries. Like I said, Zotero is a standalone software. So it's downloadable Citation manager to allow you to collect web references with just one click and then easily create a bibliography. That bibliography is you probably going to cite it in your report in one link. Zotero offer is you can create multiple libraries, and if you are working in a group, you can even share with your group members and vice versa. Let's begin with downloading Zotero in our local computer, zotero.org. You will see this download, big download button on the home page. We're going to click and it will lead us to the download page. In this video, we will be downloading both of these. The one in the left is a standalone software that will use some of space in your computer. Let's click this one. And the browser connect is basically a bridge between your search references, finding and getting that into Zotero applications that we are going to install in your hard drive. So basically this one will be installed in your hard drive, and this is the bridge between our source references that will connect. Let's install this one. It will take a couple of seconds to finish this one. I'm going to drag this one. It's also going to install the Google Chrome right to my Chrome. Boom. So it's been added to our library. I have lots of actions and I have to arrange this one. Top. You can open by using in the search bar, or you can even go to the apps finding from the bottom of your launch pad and then go to the apps, probably listed in somewhere in the here. Yes, because this one is not identified from the Apple, so it's probably going to ask, is it okay? We are going to agree with the term. Yes, if you are logging in for the first time, you are probably not going to see any of these folders that I have created for the different reports and the thesis. And these are the references. I used them in my report during my thought. So let's head to the first or foremost. We go to the Zotero website. We are going to log in. So here in a library is a collection of everything that you have. Reference list, anything you put in the folder is available in the library, but not everything you put in your library is available in a folder. So a folder can be a good organized cited link to share with a specific group members. For example, this is one of my report. I was working with three members and rest of the authors are my personal references. To create a group, go to this group menu located on the second number, click on this one. So you here you can create the group. You probably don't have anything existing, but I can explain this one. These group can be private and public. For example, you can see that I have three members on this group who can also edit references and add, edit and view. The other groups are my personal groups, so when I read them, the simple way is to create a group is just give your group a name and you can decide whether so only the member can view it in a private. This one is anyone can view it depending on your. I'm going to do this as private, so you can grant the access privilege for the group. So we go back to the group. We have a group called new group. We're going to go to manage member setting, and then we send the invitation with their email or Zotero username. You can send it to multiple people with comma separated values. if you software we install in our computer does not show the folder we just created in our group. So that is a very important process. We need to connect this Zotero with our standalone software in our computer. To do this one, go to the Zotero and preferences and go to this tab called Synchronize. Here we have to link this account. If you are not already linked, please log in with the same username and password you use for the login at Zotero.org, and then you can link it. Once you linked it, you can see the on-link window. There is one more other things you can choose here, cite window or tab. There are many styles of citation you can use in a in your report. Try using the different kind of styles. There are many of these. I would suggest also, if you are working in a university, always ask your supervisor list of the reference you will have. Some include the page numbers, some does not, and some have different styles of writing. However, you can always consult a supervisor and approve it. We are good here. We just connected. Let's synchronize this one. Right click in it. See if we are going to see our. So it took me I have to quit my Zotero apps and reopen again to get the folder I created earlier. It should not be like this, but however you understand it, says you should normally synchronize. So this is where the list of the items, if I am happy to be sharing with any others. Let's go and search. Very important reminder, your university have a library, and if you go to the list of the library they have from your university link, that will give you the direct access to the document you are looking for. Let's do this IEEE, one of the largest. Probably I'm not going to find the data, or even though if I find it, I will have a difficulties extracting them. Right now I don't have my university login, or in your university login you will have a library. From there you have the link, all this link to all these big libraries. So if you go through your university library, they are using their proxy, so you can bypass this the other direct logins, so you can have all the data, the file or the resources you are looking for. We are going to the Google Scholar and we're going to search about some topics I did research during my masters. It's over the top technology that all this brand using right now, including Netflix and others that wasn't that popular by then. The idea here is to show you how you can reflect all this in your Citation Manager, in Zotero. Let's say you found one of your article is in a PDF file. You open this, you think that this is probably the one you are citing in your report, and it's also in a PDF file. So if you think this worth saving it out, remember the plugin, the browser plugin we installed earlier. This is quite smart. It's right now is pointed as a PDF file. One click and you can save these references to your library, and you can always choose where do you want to put your list of references and which group you are searching for. Sometimes we are just googling and we happen to found something that may be related to other topics, so you can change your references anytime in any group. So for this one we are going to save in the new group that we created earlier. Done. The good thing about this connector and the PDF file and the Zotero, all these things are this PDF file is saved in your Zotero references. Of course Zotero have some boundary with how much space is and all this, how much you can store it, but for the university purpose I think if you don't use so much storage like I normally do, I have 36 MB data use, and 300 MB it's good enough for you to do a report if it is worthy, or if you are working then different, you can always change your plan to the other one, but I reckon for the students should be enough. So this citation is already saving our Zotero list. If you go here, the one we saved earlier, that's a report. So the next steps we are going to do, how to import this Zotero in our Microsoft Word. The easy way, open Microsoft Word in a computer. I'm going to using in a blank file. Remember earlier when you install this Zotero standalone software, they also have this connector, and then the Zotero running in a background. Zotero connector is running in a background to install something that support Microsoft Word. If you see here in a Microsoft, you have something called Zotero tab on your menu bar. This is basically connected. If you don't see this Zotero on top, I would suggest you to close the Word file once and then reopen it again. This is probably going to resolve the issue. Let's try with the. So here, if we wanted to insert Zotero, and especially on that, let's say we click on the Zotero add citation for the first time. You want to assess your control. We agree to the terms. So here comes this. The pop-up window will appear for the first time. So once you choose it, it's going to be the same in the further when you every time you cite it. So I'm going to choose this one for the moment, and we are going to choose the same the article we saw earlier. Boom. You can have a multiple citation. We didn't have it here. I'm going to choose one from the other folder. So these two are the two difference in the same time. And if you decided not to use one both, you can always remove them. Just like this. And couple of more. Back to this one. Add some references from different report. So the purpose of doing two here, because I want to show you how to extract this bibliography at the end. It's very simple. You can just click on the add or edit bibliography. So this is how it's going to list all the information here. Remember, you can always change the reference style. If you change to 7, the display of this one, the details will be different, if you understand what I mean. So let's go to IEEE. So IEEE have a different source of citing it. We have number 1 and number 2, a number here, and the number and number 2 down here. Number 7. So this is how it's going to cite it. You can always discuss these topics with your supervisor, because it's vary to the every universities and the supervisor how they prefer to approve your citation. Okay, I hope you learn how to use Zotero with the Microsoft Word in an easy way. If you find this tutorial is worthy, or if you think that this tutorial is helpful, if you would like to hear anything from me in the future, something like this, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Whatever you are doing, you have a nice day and good luck with your report.